चरण शरणार्थिगळु वेलकम टू क्लास नाइन मैथमेटिक्स नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑपरेशंस ऑन रियल नंबर्स ऑलरेडी यू नो रियल नंबर्स आर नथिंग बट व्हाट सेट ऑफ रैशनल एंड इरैशनल नंबर्स ऑपरेशंस इन मैथमेटिक्स आर एडिशन सब्ट्रैक्शन मल्टीप्लिकेशन एंड डिविजन दीज आर द ऑपरेशंस व्हाट विल हैपन इफ यू हैव टू ऐड सब्ट्रैक्ट मल्टीप्लाई और डिवाइड एनी रियल नंबर्स First, I'll discuss first one. The sum or difference of a rational number and an irrational number is rational number. The sum of two rational number gives us rational number only. Question is, what about rational and irrational? That is the question. See, I'll take one example. 2 is a rational number. Root 3 is a irrational number. The sum of rational and irrational number together gives us again is an irrational number. Is an irrational number. The sum of rational and irrational gives us irrational number. What about product? Later I'll discuss. What about irrational and irrational? I'll discuss later. Okay. Now, first question is the sum or difference of rational number and an irrational number is irrational number. The sum of two rational number gives us irrational number. Same, take the same number, the difference between these two also an irrational number, 2 minus root 3. The sum or difference of any two rational and irrational number gives us an irrational number only. Second one is the product or quotient, the product or division of a non-zero rational number with an irrational number is irrational. The product or division of a non-zero rational number and irrational number gives us again irrational number here. For example, 2 into root 2. See, 2 is a rational number, a root 2 is a irrational number. That gives us 2 root 2 is an irrational number. Is an irrational number. I have taken, you can take any number, no problem. 2 is a rational, root 2 is a irrational. So I'll take division 3 divided by root 3. See, one is rational, another one is irrational number. This is also an irrational number. What you have to conclude by seeing this one? The product or quotient of a non-zero rational number with an irrational number is irrational. The sum or difference of a rational number and an irrational number is also an irrational number. Next one is, if we add, subtract, multiply or divide two irrationals, the result may be rational or irrational. Here, the sum of rational and irrational or difference of rational and irrational gives us irrational. The product or quotient of rational and irrational gives us irrational. But next one is, what about irrational, two irrational numbers? It may be rational or irrational. For example, root 2 plus root 3. See, root 3, the sum of two irrational numbers is again irrational number only. And irrational number. One more example, root 2 minus root 2 is equal to 0. See, if you have to take different irrational numbers, or you can take same rational number. See, take different irrational number, the sum of 2 is an irrational number. Take the same irrational number and you have to subtract, it gives us 0. 0 is a rational number. 0 is a rational number. 0 is a rational number. Next, one more example. 3 root 3 minus root 3. See, 3 root 3 is irrational number. This is also irrational number. That gives us 3 into 1 root 3. 3 into root 3 minus 1 root 3. That gives us 2 root 3 is irrational number. This is what? Irrational number. Next, root 5 divided by root 3. This is also rational number. Irrational number. This is irrational number. Next, one more example. Same numbers, for example, root 2 divided by root 2, you have to take, that gives us 1 is rational number. 1 is rational number. So, what we have to conclude here? If we add, subtract, multiply or divide two irrational, the result may be either rational or irrational based on the condition. Based on the condition. I hope you understood this one. Next, I am going to discuss geometric representation of root x. Geometric representation of root x. That is nothing but what? Square root of decimal numbers on the number line. Where x is greater than 0. Where x is greater than 0. This is a question. One example I have taken here. Represent square root of 5.6 on the number line. Okay. So represent square root of 5.6 on the number line. Here you have to take your scale and pencil. Scale and pencil you have to take and draw one line. And draw one line. Draw a line of any length and next root of 5.6. So 5.6 exactly 5.6 you have to take, and after that 5.6, see, draw a line of any length. Next, measure 5.6. Consider this is A, this is B. After this 5.6, one more unit, that is one more centimeter, you have to take from point B. Consider this is C. Consider this is C. Now AC is a length. You have to divide AC. It is nothing but what? Point or bisect AC. Find the midpoint of AC by using your compasses. By using your compasses, AC you have to bisect. More than half of this AC, it is nothing but what? Whatever length you have to take, more than half of AC radius you have to take, draw arc upside and downside. Similarly, by making C as a center, you are bisecting AC, not AB. Okay, so join here, you will get one point. See, you will get one point here. So no need to join, just to point this point. So this point is a O. O is the midpoint of AC. Now by making O as a center, A, OA and OC as a radius, you have to draw one semicircle. Like you have to draw a semicircle by using O as a center. See, this length is 5.6. So this is 5.6 centimeter. Now you have to draw one perpendicular at B. By using your protractor, at B you have to draw a perpendicular. Make B as a center, you have to draw a perpendicular. So it goes upside till the arc, till the circumference of the semicircle, you have to draw a line. So no need to draw till here, we need up to here. First you have to adjust up to here only, you have to draw here. Mention this is a D. Now you have to make BD as a radius. Draw a arc from here to this line. Adjust the compass, only this length. See, you have to draw dotted line. From here you have to draw, it touches this line at E, because D is given here, this is E. This will be square root of 5.6. See, this length is 1 centimeter. This is 5.6 centimeter. Okay, this is 5.6 centimeter. This is 1 centimeter. This is 1 centimeter. So this gives us square root of 5.6. 6. This gives us square root of 5.6 by Pythagoras theorem. Next, by using the same length, you have to draw arc here. It touches the line at E. This E gives us root of 5.6. This is the procedure. We have to represent the square root of decimal numbers on the number line. If it is a root of 10.1, you can take here 10.1 plus 1 unit here. Same procedure should be followed. Again, you have to bisect this AC point midpoint, draw a semicircle here. By using this B as a base or point, you have to draw a perpendicular here, perpendicular. So next, by using the same length of BD, you have to draw a arc. It touches the line at E. This E gives us a root of 5.6 on the number line. This is the procedure we have to follow. We have to construct or we have to represent these numbers on the number line.